There are urgent calls to fix the bottom of the South-Eastern Freeway after yet another near disaster at the deadly intersection.
A runaway truck barreled straight through it. Police and witnesses agree it's sheer luck no one was killed.
It's an all too familiar sight, a smashed up truck at the bottom of the freeway.
I heard a loud thud, very scary.
The out of control concrete truck hurtled down the hill, crossed eight lanes and the median strip on Cross Road before slamming into a concrete wall. The only saving grace this time, it was 4 in the morning.
Maybe an hour or so later, and I think we could have had much more devastating consequences with a potential loss of life.
If it was in the daytime, there would be plenty of cars around.
It's happened before where people have died.
Lucky to the truck driver, a 65-year-old Millicent man who survived the impact. He had to be cut from the cabin and was taken to the Royal Adelaide with broken bones.
It would have been quite a scary episode for him, yeah.
The smash caused traffic chaos through the morning peak and for much of the day as crews worked to clear the mess, reinforce the wall and tow the mangled wreck, allowing Cross Road to reopen 10 hours later. Police say it's too early to confirm if a mechanical failure is to blame, but it is eerily similar to this 2014 tragedy at the same spot. On that day, a sewage truck's brakes failed, sending it ploughing into cars stopped at the lights, killing 2 people. Motorists were fed up then.
Do you remember the other truck that cleaned up cars about 2-3 months ago? It's just the same thing, repeating it.
And a decade later, they're questioning why it's still happening.
How many accidents have we had on this intersection?
Kimberly Pratt, 7 News.
Well, live now to Kim Eklund-Osman. And Kim, more clearly needs to be done there, but what?
Rosanna, that is the million-dollar question being asked by locals and motorists who use the freeway every day. We know whenever a terrible crash like this happens, debate rages about the best way to stop trucks putting lives at risk, with ideas ranging from a third arrestor bed to a bypass. And authorities have tried lowering speed limits, upgrading signage and educating truckies. But let's be honest, it's not working. Last night's federal budget included $100 million of safety upgrades for the freeway. It seems fixing this death trap would be the best way to spend it.